Now let's discuss how efficiency is impacted in the competitive market. When I say competitive market, I'm referring to an unregulated market that is governed by the forces of supply and demand. Left alone, the market will reach a point of equilibrium where the quantity supplied of a good equals its quantity demanded at some price. At equilibrium, the total surplus of the economy, equal to the consumer surplus plus the producer surplus, is maximized. There are instances where the market isn't as efficient as it could be. Market failure refers to a situation where the market is not producing at equilibrium for whatever reason. We'll discuss these reasons in just a bit. Suppose that, for whatever reason, the market is underproducing the good in question, which means that the quantity supplied of the good is less than the equilibrium quantity. This drives the price up because buyers start to bid for the good, but it creates something known as deadweight loss. In essence, deadweight loss is a decrease in social surplus due to inefficient resource allocation. The red triangle represents the deadweight loss in this particular scenario. Similarly, sometimes an economy might overproduce a good. Again, I'll go through some of the reasons why this might happen in just a bit. In this scenario, the quantity supplied of the good exceeds the equilibrium quantity, so producers are producing more than the optimal amount. This results in the price being driven down and creates a similar deadweight loss situation as the previous example. It might not be as intuitive from the graph on screen right now, but I encourage you to find problem sets with questions relating to market failure and practicing social surplus calculations to understand why overproduction and underproduction result in lower social surplus. Market failure can happen for a number of reasons, and in the rest of the course, I'll explore them in more detail. For now, just understand that any sort of regulations, taxes or subsidies, externalities, etc., change the amount that is actually produced and consumed relative to the equilibrium in the economy. Thus, all of these are considered to be sources of market failure. If we don't use the competitive market as a means of allocating resources, we can consider using any of the allocation methods I talked about in the first part of this lecture. The idea is that there is no quote-unquote perfect allocation method, but the competitive market seems to work the best for goods and services.